I love you, YouTubes. All you YouTubers out there, let me give you a kiss.
All right, now.
Let me get some spot. Hold on.
Hold on, yeah.
Now, I'm gonna see if I can relax. I watched me some Roger Hansen and some Story Waters videos, and they got me all in the relaxed mood. So. Of course, you know I had to have a comeback though, right? I've only been without internet at my house for a year. I've only had the power cut and the water cut off for a year. Now, I just called the bank yesterday at the end of the day. And they did say that they overdrafted my account, my checking account, for $528. And that the electric company did get paid. That was the only check that went through. And as soon as that first check went overdraft, they stopped all other checks. And I called the bank. I said, well, can't you at least let it go for the next two checks, one for $125 and one for $283? They said, well, the computer only makes those decisions. And I said, well, get me the person who runs the computer, man. Let me talk to him. Well, it's a computer. I said, no, some man programs the computer. But it's the computer. Only the computer makes the decisions. No. Who built those computers, people? I did. Okay, now that we got that situated. So, of course, if you read my other videos, you know what's going on with that commercial lien I put in. And how I just gave the international military an order. It wasn't an order. It was an order. See, there's a difference between an order and an order. As in, to restore order back on the planet. Not an order to it. It's order. Law and order. Peace and safety. Honor. Not order. Dishonor. New one world order. See? Ah.
Likes to death.
Yeah, love from the boobs. I had to let that one out. Now, let's see if I can relax in a historically Rogered way with my handsome self. So, like I was saying, I finally got my power on, so all the last 15 videos I made were all ejaculation videos. Ejaculation of the personality character mouth. Now that I'm at home and I can ejaculate on the videos with my character and mouth. I'm not talking about jacking the jizz. I ain't jacked my jizz for a month. And it's going to be another long freaking while before I ain't going to jack my jizz ever again. My jizz is staying right inside me. Because that's the reality I'm creating. If you want to shoot your jizz, that's up to you. Don't let me influence you. But if I inspire you to keep your jizz, and you have the understanding and the wisdom to fulfill your jizzin' life, so be it. And there's the cock that just crowed, Mother Nature's confirmation. You didn't hear it probably, but I did. Check out my hair shadow, man. See that? Sasquatch. Look at the Sasquatch shadow. Look at that. Sasquatch. That's Sasquatch, man. Sasquatch speaking. Look at this profile. Sasquatch. Hey, call me Sasquatch. See? Sasquatch. The wise Sasquatch. So, like I was saying, I got all my ejaculations out. All my excitement. Finally having my own space. So I can... otherwise, I had to go to the library, and I had to go to the Jack in the Box, and I had to do everything in a safe, hazard-free, so that the public don't riot manner, till such time as I manifest being this way in the public. And that comes through fame. When you get fame, everybody realizes the greatness and the sense of well-being that you intend with all your character, and then they actually want you to be that way. That's why you get people like Robin Williams can go on TV and they can just be themselves, because they're famous. And that's where I'm headed. And then I will be this way in front of everybody at all times. Just be myself, ejaculating everywhere, or holding back. And I'm talking about my character. That exudes from me, man. But one of the things that I've noticed about myself is that when I do get around a lot of people, I tend to get super relaxed because I know everything and I see everything, and you know, it's just like, you could all just be yourselves also. Especially the idea and it's not like if you could all just be yourselves as in I'm so great, it's I wish we could all be ourselves together with no more fears. And it's going to get that way. Mark my words. I just happen to be the leading king to set the standard, to bring us all up to the level of kingship side by side in balance. Not off balance. It's a little uncomfortable being off balance, isn't it? Balance, straight up and down, right in the middle. Leaning side to side, touching. What's up, brother? What's up, brother? What's going on there, brother? Give you a little rub behind the head. You know? Relax. Humanity. Compassion, affection, reality. I just watched my Ozzy Osbourne video last night. And I got to see young Ozzy and young Tony Iommi and Geezer the Butler and whatever the drummer's name was. Bill Ward, yeah. Oh, Bill Ward probably might have been the bassist and Geezer the Butler was the drummer. And they showed some behind the scenes of his feet pumping up and down on the cymbals and the bass drum. You rarely ever see that these days, do you? So you can get a hint for what the rhythm is of the body that's going. You want that rear view so you can see what's going on. You can't see anything with the drums in front of their feet. You want to see their feet pumping, man, and their elbows pumping. That way you can mimic the rhythm. You're pumping the feet, man. Now, those ideas that just went through your head were your own. I have my ideas of what all that body language meant, but you have your own. And so you have to make peace with your own ideas of what they mean for you and what they were communicating for you. Because they communicate something for me totally different than what they're communicating for you. But yet, at the end of the day, it's all the same. It's all the same language, and it means all the same thing. Because your definition, my definition, although they might give the appearance of something different, it's all the same. Okay.
Yeah, it's all the same. I'm so nice and relaxed. Finally got my relaxation on. Been tensed up for a year. Cold out there by in the backyard during the wintertime. Oh, we had a little tiny rocket stove, but we had a heater.
Heated rocket stove. So yeah, so now I can just sit back and relax, man. See how it is? See how nice it is when we, you know? Just be yourself. You listen to the birds. Keep the doors of your house open. Put a lien on the corporation so you can pump the heaters up at full blast and have the doors open during the wintertime. Because you need that mix of fresh air and polluted air. That's where your immune system pumps, jumps. That way you can hear the birds outside tweeting, the horns trading, the cocks crowing. My neighbor has a cock and some chickens. You hear the owls hooting, the different birds, the frogs, the crickets, the planes coming across, low planes, high jets, train horns, sirens. These are all manufactured extensions of Mother Nature as well as the live versions, the trees, the wind blowing. You hear the wind in the trees, the rivers flowing, the oceans, everything. Remember, it's a balance of inner thought and the outer Mother Nature. And what helps is cannabis. Cannabis. Yeah. And soon I'm going to have access to some LSD. I'm going to take some LSD for the first time. That's like acid. Deep, deep, deep revelatory thoughts from all the studies that I've done. I've never taken it yet, except once when I was about 16 years old, and I wasn't ready for it, and I kind of went on a trip, kind of like a paranoid trip, but yet at the same time, it revealed something to me that I realize now is, wow, there was a lot of truth in that revelation that I had. That was eons ago, man. That was 16. I'm 47 now, so let's say 46 to 16, 30 years ago. But now I'm ready for another hit of LSD. Ayahuasca, whatever they call it. It's all the same thing. It's just extrasensory, mind-enhancing mineral salts from the earth, from Mother Nature. Anything you put into your body is from Mother Nature, whether you chemically mix it or artificially make it. All those ingredients come from Mother Nature. There's nothing bad on the earth. Now, if you go into gluttony, well, then your body will pay for it. You eat too many Kentucky Fried Chickens, your body will probably pay for it until you learn how to regulate your thoughts to overcome everything. Same thing. If you take too many mineral salts of the earth, a certain mineral salt, called gluttony, and gluttony can easily turn into addiction. What they call shooting up the needle all the time, heroin, drug addiction. You know, if you do it all the time, it's just an addiction, right? And you kind of turn into a crackhead or a crack baby, whatnot. Well, that's no different from someone getting on a YouTube video all the time and being imbalanced. All it is an imbalance. Gluttony is just an imbalance. So you just apply that principle to every aspect in your life, to your thinking. You know, sure, we can point the finger at the heroin addicts or the crack babies and all that, the crack mothers, and say, oh, look at them. Ah. But deep inside your own thoughts, you're just as much as a crack baby. It's just that people can't see it. People can't see your thoughts. Deep inside, you have the most corrupt, corroded thoughts going on. But yet you point the finger at everybody else that you see on the outside and say, oh, look at them. Oh, man. God, that's terrible. Ah. That's called hypocrisy. Hypocrisy, man. Remember, there is no more blame in the world of healing. There's no more blame, no more pointing of the fingers. And the reason the people that you see on the outside that are hooked on crack and all that other good stuff is because everybody's pointing a finger at them. It's called the strong pound of the weak. You know I'm right. Shake your heads. Like the good yogi always does for the crowd. He says, you know that's right, don't you? Come on now. Give me some feedback. I want to hear some yes. Not just from one or two people, I want to hear some yes from everybody. So we're going to sit here until everybody's shaking their head all at the same time. So now we're just going to sit here and be quiet and let everyone meditate on that thought for a few minutes here. And I'm going to ask you the question again until I get everyone's head nodding. Let's just all just sit and relax and meditate on that one thought right now. All of the harm that's being caused in this earth is because everybody's pointing a finger at everybody saying, ah, look at you. Ha ha ha. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't do that. So let's sit back and reflect on that. If you got your joints, fire up your joints. If you got some acid, fire it up, because we're going to sit here until the truth comes through. We ain't going nowhere. So just relax. If you need a shot of alcohol, go get a drink. We're going to sit here and we're going to break through. We're going to break through till we all nod our heads together as one. Remember, you tuned in to me. I ain't forcing myself on you. You came to me. I'm the leader. I'm the good leader. If you have to, turn on the TV, turn on the music, whatever you got to do. We're just going to sit here until the revelation finally strikes. Because remember, the toughest part in life that you're ever going to encounter is called waiting. But you can quantum leap quick in the process and tell yourself, it's not going to take me that long to figure it out. I'm going to come to a quick conclusion. As you speak, so your reality comes. As you think, so your reality manifests. So we're just going to sit here. And I want to see every comment on this video a yes. I'm expecting that. I'm expecting yes, 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 you're right. Yes, 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 you're right. We're going to sit here till we get all yeses. So, I'm going to go get something to eat. If you need to get something to eat, remember, we're still all connected. Think about it till you get your yes. If you got to snuggle up to your cat and give them a kiss or sniff their butt, you do what it takes. It's time to get real, people. All right? It can happen. It's going to happen. In fact, it's here now. And it's growing rapidly.
Easy.
It's my favorite thing in the whole world. In India, in the country of India, all the animals and the people drink from the same water and they eat from the same bowls. They share their saliva because the saliva is essential for sharing the immune system. India has the healthiest people on the earth. And just remember, the United States just bonded with India, so we're going to exchange information, our technology, for their gut feeling of how health is naturally acquired. Now, you don't just jump right in with animal saliva. You do it a little bit at a time. One lick a day for a good long time, then move it to two licks, then three licks, then let them lick your nose, and let them rub their nose on your nose every once in a while, just little bits. Your body will tell you when it's too much, because you'll be like, man, that's all I can take. Till finally you can just rub noses with your cats and share snot. It's all just immune system transfer. Think about these things. this is what I learned how to do very intensely over this past summer and winter. And I've never gotten sick, and I've never caught in a cold. He's just like the man who plays with scorpions. He lets the scorpions sting him just a little bit. But first, you know, he introduces his body to the scorpion sting, or the snake's bite, or the snake's venom. You take it a little bit at a time, and then you slowly build up an immunity to it. But you gotta be willing to do it. And that takes understanding, wisdom, knowledge. That which is much more precious than gold. Because all the resources here on the earth are here for us to share without money. But we needed the money system to teach us how to distribute it all evenly so no one hoards. That's what the lean process is all about. Commercial lean, security agreement, solutions in commerce. Type it in the YouTube search and begin your journey in education in real law, universal law. So are you still keeping it in your back of your mind for that yes? All the problems in our world are because we're pointing the finger at everybody? Ain't that a big yes? I don't see everybody shaking their heads yet, so we're going to sit here until it all happens. I know you all need some more time to regulate and think about it. I'm not pointing the finger at you just because I said you're not shaking your head yet. And I'm insisting that you have to shake your head. Please. Don't shake your head because I'm telling you or because I'm suggesting. Well, you stand your own ground. You learn how to stand your own ground. Don't be scared off of it. You got to go through the fear. And the most intense fear you're ever going to sense is the cop or the sheriff knocking on your door or the attorney sending you letters in the mail saying, we got a lien right on you. We're going to foreclose on you. Letter after letter after letter. Court judgment after court judgment. And if you give in to them by running away or bowing down to their suggestions, their assumptive jurisdiction, then you ain't going to pass the test of fear. The most potent test you're ever going to face in your life of fear. Remember, fear has many different levels. And if you want to take it to the highest level, then sign yourself out of prison planet. Be my guest. In your own time, though. Take your time. Take your time. But if you get all red-eyed and everything while you're doing it, fine. That's just something you gotta go through. Just embrace it. Because we ain't entered perfection yet. We're getting there. And you don't have to type in yes at the bottom. You got the door open? Can you hear the birds tweeting outside where you're at? Can you hear the river? Can you hear the cocks crowing, the birds, the frogs, the wind? Can you see the sun? Can you feel the sun? My next step is to open up that front window. Pull the curtains up. Pull the blind. With my guitars all leaned up on the couch. Got 5 guitars right in front of the window. There's an overcoming of fear right there. What's the fear thought that comes in? Oh, people will see my nice guitars and want to steal them. Oh, ain't no one going to steal anything from me. In fact, I'm leaned up so strong, everybody in the city knows who I am. I'm the guru of the town who preaches live from the backyard with his imaginary radio station for all the neighbors around to hear it. And I got a public bike path going through my backyard. It's an easement of electrical lines, power lines. So they put a bike path going all the way down. So I got public listening to me, everything. Everybody knows who I am. All my papers are in the court. All the cops know who I am. Everybody in the town knows who I am. And they realize now they have to serve me and protect me because they realize I'm the king. I'm the king of this area. That's what a true yogi is. So now I'm beginning to grow more and more into that. Till my fame spreads to every person in the town. And yes, I've had public access television show here too. And I quit for last year, 2 years ago, because I had to go underground. Because I had to face the giant, commercial wing, all the courts and attorneys coming after me, the sheriffs, everything, whole 9 yards. I had to go into hiding. Because I was dealing with facing my fears. Part of facing my fears is I had to go into hiding. Sheriffs came knocking on the door. So I got up at 3 o'clock every morning, went down to the river and hid down there. Then I hid all through the town. I stayed away from that because we got 2 cities where I'm at. I'm in one city, the sheriffs are in the other city. I got up at 3 a.m. in the morning for 2 weeks because they were knocking on the door. 3 a.m. I knew they didn't get to work till about 8 in the morning, so and I knew they got off work about 5. So went down to the river at 3 a.m. to be safe, 2 hours early every morning. And I got home at about 12 midnight. So I got about 2 hours of sleep for 2 or 3 hours of sleep for 2 weeks straight. Hiding. Till when I was monitoring the sheriff's websites to see how many times they were knocking on my door, because they record it all in the public. And then I monitored it to see what their comments were. And they finally put the comment on their website. It said, unlocatable, can't find. And I went to the court and I looked in the court records and there was their paper in the court records. We can't find them. all knew this. They knew I was out there hiding. And they knew I was walking through the other city, too. I went right to the city where they were all at. I was walking around the city. But they can't pick me. They can't pick you up in the city. They can only come to your house and knock on your door. Or they can go to your workplace. Unless they really know you well, but the people here didn't really know me that well back then. Although they had an idea who I was. So I played along with the legal rules for a little bit. I said, oh, okay, well. They really can't pick me up on the street because there's no warrant. I ain't doing anything, any criminal acts, so they had no reason to come question me. I wasn't breaking any legal codes. Although at one point I was standing outside the back of a bar and they had a sign up there that said no loitering. I didn't realize it. And the cop drove right by me and looked at me and I looked straight at him, nodded my head, and he just kept on going. Till finally one of the ladies out there came by and said, hey, there's no loitering here. And I said, oh, shit. Well, I didn't realize that. Sorry. But I didn't have my lean in when the sheriffs came knocking on the door. I didn't understand the lean back then. And I was able to acquire some 10 seminars, Seattle seminar, whatever all the names of the cities were. Back then, 2009 seminars, man. All those seminars, yeah, around there, 2008, 2009, 2010, and then the commercial lean DVD, single DVD, and the Paul Zaccardi A for V DVD. All of a sudden, my eyes were open to how the court systems work, how the commercial lean is, what A for V is, everything. It all came together finally. And once I understood it, I did not allow no sleep to my eyes till I typed up 150 pages worth of court papers. I wrote three books, 350-page books, as well as my commercial lien. And I finally figured out how to register it with the Secretary of State. John Q. Public, Trust. State will take that. Otherwise, they'll kick you right out. They'll say, who's this dude putting a lien on himself? We don't do that. You put John Q. Public, Trust. But you don't need the state. You don't need to use the state's registry program. All you got to do is just put it on your own private website or post it on the front of your house. Put it on your car. Put it on the telephone pole. Write it on your t-shirt. Put it up and walk through town with the same t-shirt. I'm leaned up. Do whatever you do. Any record's good public record. You don't have to go down to the courthouse. You don't. They'll say you do. The legal system will say, oh, you got to use the courthouse. And then when you go down there to register it, say, oh, we don't record these. Just record it wherever you want. Create your own website. Put it on YouTube video. Put it on your YouTube site. Put it on your Facebook. There's free websites. You can have free websites post documents up there. Put it on there. So they come knocking on your door, you say, hey, there's my website, there's my link, go check it out. Oh, and they'll go talk to the judge, and the judge will go, oh, shit, I'll leave that dude alone. But we'll send them some, we'll try to scare them away. So they'll just send cops near your house all the time, drive by your house, sheriffs drive by your house, you know, they'll just follow you around to the town, all that, and send you letters in the mail, attorney letters in the mail, banker collection letters. We're going to foreclose on you. We're going to repossess your cars, your houses, all your property. They'll send you all that in the mail. And you'll be like, that's no shit. You want to face the fears of your life? Once you face the fears of your life, then you'll get honor and fame. True honor and true fame. Like I said, once you get true honor and true fame, then your full character will be able to come out wherever you are, because everybody will know who you are. They'll know the intention, the sweet intentions of your heart, and you can do whatever you want, act any way you want in public, and it will spread like wildfire. Other people will start doing it too, and then we'll have a brand new world just like that. King. Not only am I from the bloodline of the tribe of Judah, who was given self-appointed to be the rulers of the earth, the law enforcement, the strong arms of the law. Then the natives of the land. I'm a bloodline of the mix of the natives of the land, the Iroquois Indian, who were undefeatable by the corporation till the corporation tricked them. But Mother Nature intended it, because the Iroquois Indian had to come under the birth certificate in order to come back out free, to put a lien on their share of the resources of the earth. This second phase called Prison Planet, which had to happen because we were killing each other in the jungle. So some smart men who were led by the collective consciousness of the spirits and Mother Nature came up with smart ideas. Let's create cities and put everybody under rules. No more killing each other. No more punching each other out. No more looking at each other mean-like. These are all acts of terrorists. You pass by someone at the street, and they spit on the street as they pass you by. And you can sense it's an insult. That's a terrorist act. They deserve to be ticketed, fined. But there's a difference in motive and intention. If they pass you by and they spit, and then they look at you and say, oh, sorry about that, I had to spit that out. And they mean it good, they just had to spit. That's totally different. That's not a terrorist act. That's trying to be themselves and find their comfortability and maintain the peace and say, hey, man, I hope I wasn't disturbing you when I did that. You know, excuse me, I got to spit. I hope you don't mind. Man, I had to get that out of my mouth. I hope you can understand that. I don't mean any harm for you. The intention of your heart, if you verbalize it to your neighbors, everybody you pass by on the street, that's all it takes. But if you don't, it's going to be interpreted as a terrorist act. And eventually, if you do that, when a cop passes you by, I'm giving him all the authority in the world to knock you in the teeth with his club. I'm the king, and I just gave an order. And as soon as our citizens learn how to do citizens' arrest, and you pass by and spit insolently or do anything, give anybody a citizen a mean look, they got all the reason in the world to pull out their gun and cuff your ass and take your ass in and write a report. till such time as all the, you know, terrorists get rehabbed, you may realize, oh, and the only reason that way they're going to get rehabbed is because they listen to me and people like me who explain to them how the real world works. And once they see how the real world works, they'll say, oh, shit, I didn't know that. Damn, now I see it. Now I have the wisdom and understanding to actually want to be peaceful. Damn. Shit. It's just like the Apostle Paul in the story of the Bible. He didn't understand, man. Till his thought knocked him off his high horse, the Most High. They call it the Lord knocked him off his high horse. You know? And he said to him, shit, I was ignorant. I didn't know. He says, God, now I see. I'm a peaceful man now. So, down with your clowns.